Hello, my name is Becky, and I'm an educator at the Nasher. We're about to look at a sculpture called Low Landscape, number 3, by artist Dorothy Daner. As you can see, this sculpture is much wider than it is tall. In fact, it's only 7.5 inches tall. This low horizontal orientation helps us imagine an abstract landscape. This means that it is not like a realistic copy of any other piece of land. In fact, no part of this sculpture looks exactly like an object we recognize. When Daner creates landscapes in an abstract language, we can understand the general idea and make our own meaning from the work. Imagine for a moment that you've shrunk and are only 6 inches tall. Place your tiny self inside this landscape. Which walls would you want to climb? Where would you find a good place to hide? Can you find the perfect place to grind your skateboard? Where would you want to have a picnic? The artist, Dorothy Daner, used an interesting process to create this sculpture. She began by modeling an individual pieces out of wax. Then she assembled those pieces to construct a model. She drew on the wax slabs to introduce textures. For the last step, she cast the modeled shape in bronze. Now, here's something for you to try at home. Step 1. Begin by studying the walls of one room in your home. Is your space a perfect square? Does it have more than 4 sides? Are some walls longer than others? Do the sides meet at a 90-degree angle? Step 2. Let's use those observations to sketch a map of your space from a bird's eye view. First, draw the exterior border of the room. Next, add simple shapes to represent every object in the space. For example, a couch might be a rectangle. Remember, you are not drawing the objects, you're just representing them with a geometric shape. Step 3, look around your house and collect cardboard boxes. Look for a variety of sizes, colors, and shapes. These boxes will represent the objects in your space. Cereal boxes work great for this exercise, and you do not need to empty them. Step 4. Find an empty table or floor space to create a sculpture of your map. It will be larger than your drawing, but smaller than the actual room. Set up the boxes on the floor to represent the objects in the room. You can make walls out of string or masking tape. Step 5. Invite someone to look at your sculpture and see if they can figure out which room you recreated. You can find additional resources related to this artwork in the description of the video. See you at the next artwork!